It's the trooper.
Damn, crazy people just sleeping right on the sidewalk. That ain't even a sidewalk, it's a fucking construction area. Yo, I was so beat last night. By the time I got home and got out of the shower from work, it was 4 a.m. So I didn't edit the vlog last night, so I'm gonna go edit it today. So that means I'm probably not gonna be playing poker today. Gotta run by the bank, by the ATM here real quick. Apparently some people noticed that I drive the wrong way when I drive in the bank because I'm driving against the arrows. First of all, I did that on purpose to show you that I'm driving against the arrows, as if to mock defiance. But the truth is, first of all, that bank is closed. There's no branch there. I think there's some offices in the top, but there's very little activity in that parking lot. Second of all, in order to go in the proper way to this bank, you gotta drive down like 2 blocks and then go down and then come around and drive back up 2 blocks. Because of the one-way streets. So here we go again. I'm driving in the wrong way. And there's nobody here. It's practically a vacant lot for the most part. I mean, there's a couple of cars parked here because I think there are a couple of people who work in offices up there. This used to be a Wells Fargo branch. And there was drive-through window right here and all that shit. But all that shit's closed. So I'll drive whichever way I want. See, there's no one working in the drive-through window. So don't tell me. So here's a thought on poker that I've had for a long time. And I really first started thinking about it when I was back in Jacksonville, because there was this one situation where it's basically about chopping the blinds. So just in case you don't know about chopping the blinds, because I run into a lot of people from different countries and things and people that only play online that don't understand what chopping the blinds even is. So in a live cash game in most places, definitely everywhere in Vegas, if it folds around pre-flop to the small blind, then the big and small blind have the option to chop. Basically just take their money back, move the button one spot, and go on to the next hand. So there's no rake for the house, there's no hand actually played. Most people prefer to do this, and there's a bunch of different reasons why people prefer to do it, and then there are some people that prefer not to do it. So we should look at the reasons on both sides and figure out what's best for you, you know? Basically, the story that started me really thinking about whether or not I should or should not chop the blinds is it happened in Jacksonville, Florida, when it folded to me in the small blind and I offered to chop with the guy on my left, and he said, yeah, he always chops. And I mentioned, because I'd never seen the guy before, I mentioned, like, if you have a bad beat hand or a, you know, they paid bonuses for royals and steel wheels or whatever. I'm like, if you have a draw to something like that, I don't mind, you know? And he was like, no, and he thought it was ridiculous that I would even suggest that he would want to see the flop to try to hit a bonus. And I tried to explain to him what my point was, and he still didn't get it. Because the people that want to see the flops for bonus hands and bad beats and things like that are mostly recreational players. They're the players that we need in the game in order for the game to be profitable. So, you know, if I always chop with a guy and all of a sudden he wants to see the flop, and I understand the reason he wants to see the flop is because he has a royal flush possibility, then let the guy see it. You know what I mean? I'm accommodating to the recreational players in this manner. But the fact that this guy was so far removed from being accommodating to, you know, other players in the game who might or might not be recreational players, you know, just kind of struck me or whatever. So the people that don't chop, most of the time they're pros, right? They're people who believe they have such an edge over the other player that they're losing money by chopping. I played with a guy like this just 2 days ago. I don't know if he is a pro. Sat down, did not chop with anyone. And for me, first of all, let me tell you my stance. As far as I'm concerned, I always do what the other person wants to do, but I wanted to be consistent. So if you want to chop, we chop. If you don't want to chop, I'm not going to get mad about it. I don't care. It's up to you, because I feel like I have an edge. So I don't mind being friendly when it comes to chopping the blinds. How profitable can you really be? Especially when 50% of the time you're gonna be out of position when you don't chop the blinds, because you're gonna be in the small blind. I understand that it's much easier to outplay recreational players from out of position. You don't have to be in position to win a hand or be profitable every single time. But it does make a big difference. So you're also going to be playing heads up in what is usually going to be a small pot that is going to be raked. So 10% of the pot's going away. I feel like when that guy didn't chop the other day, he was basically saying, oh, look at me, I'm better than you, I have an edge, I'm not giving away money for free, kind of an attitude or whatever. And I just think it's a little bit harsh to tourists and recreational players when you don't chop the blinds. So that's basically the reason that I chop the blind is to be friendly. You know what I mean? I'm not going to be that profitable blind versus blind. I mean, I do believe that I would be profitable against recreational players from the blinds. You know, and people like to talk about, oh, well, nobody makes money from the blinds. Nobody's profitable from the blinds. But when they say that, I'm not really sure if they're talking about blind versus blind or just from the blinds overall. So yeah, from the small blind, you're probably going to be a lot less profitable than you are from the cutoff if you're considering playing every hand from the small blind and playing every hand from the cutoff. So I don't really know. I think it's very difficult to ascertain the real numbers and get a real sample. I mean, a lot of people can look at their own personal numbers from online poker, and with online poker it's different. I mean, in online poker you may not can be profitable from the blinds, but even if I can be profitable from the small blind against a rec player in the big blind, I'm gonna chop with that guy, move on, save the time, save the rake, get the button the next hand, and then be much more profitable from the button and be much more well received from the recreational player who wanted to chop. At the same time, if it cost me a dollar to allow a rec player to see a bad beat possibility or a royal flush possibility, high hands or something like that, you got to understand something about the high hands and the promo hands and all that stuff. That is what brings the rec players to the game. It's like rec players love splash pots. They love high hands, they love bad beats, they love all that stuff. So if it folds around to me in the small, and this guy and I, we usually chop, but he looks down at ace, king of hearts, and he wants to see if he can make a royal flush to win $200 or $500 or whatever it is, most of the time the guy who's looking at the high hand is going to give you your money back anyway. So if it's 1-2 and it folds around to me and he's like, can we see the flop? And I call a dollar, normally he's gonna give me either, I'm gonna win the pot when we check it all the way down, or he's gonna make a royal and bet the minimum amount to make the pot the minimum amount in order to qualify. If he wins the hand, he's gonna give me my $2 back. It almost always happens that way. And there won't be a rake if it's a $4 pot. If you're playing 2-5, yeah. This situation in Jacksonville was 2-5. When I offered to let the guy see the flop if he wanted to, and he found it absurd. So yeah, there would be a rake coming out or whatever, but I think you see the point. You should always allow the rec players to see jackpot hands and things like that, because that's the reason they're in the room. Let them have their fun and let them focus on things that are unprofitable. Promo hands are not profitable, right? So let them focus on the things that are not profitable. That's my opinion. That is my thought on poker for today. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Tell your friends about it so they can watch it too. Leave a comment below, and I'll see you next time.